Hey guys, this is Yasalom, and today I'll be going through patch 3.10 and how it affects Twisted Tree Line. First of all, with Ashe, they changed her passive and buffed it, so she'll be critting more often now, and they fixed a minor bug. Overall, it's not gonna affect her much on Twisted Tree Line, and she's still gonna be less viable than other AD carries because she lacks mobility. With Elise, they reduced the health of the Splatterlings and they increased armor and magic resist, and they reduced the damage they take from AoE spells. Basically, what they want to do with this is make them less vulnerable to AoE spells from casters so they don't die that easily. I think this change is for fires, because when you're trying to donate a buff to someone, their Splatterlings would still keep attacking it, and sometimes it would steal the buff. Go closer, it's not important. Her W, they reduced the movement speed, because it's really hard to dodge her W or escape from it, because it moves so fast, so that's actually a good one. Their pearl changes. She no longer can descend outside the area. Okay, this was actually a really annoying bug where even after you escape the circle, she can still jump on you with her pearl. So that's actually a good nerf. And here they fixed the bug where Elise could use her abilities while she was still untargetable after she goes down from repel, so that's also good. And now the Splatterlings comes down slightly after Elise comes down from repel, so that's also good. Fiddlesticks can reduce the magic resist of Baron, Dragon, or Valmau, which he wasn't supposed to in the first list, so that's actually a good fix, bug fix. Okay, this bug was really annoying where Fizz could use a spell and it would do no damage. And after they fix it, now Fizz is gonna be a lot more viable on threes. Now they changed the way how Karthus Q works, so before, when you click out of his range, out of his Q range, the spell doesn't cast. But now, if you click out of his max range, the spell casts. They reduced the defile scaling. Not that important. Okay, there was the bug where you could spam your E rapidly, and it would do more damage. And they fixed that now. I think this is where sometimes you queue a brush and there's someone inside there, but it doesn't show that there's someone inside there, so that's a bug fix, I think. Switch targets. This is a fix to the voidlings and how they target things. Master Yi Make. Overall, it's a buff to his late game, but he still has the same early game problems as the old Master Yi in 3s, which is he can't really do much in early skirmishes like before 6 or such, so he can't really defend the altar or jungle. And in team fights later on, he's still really vulnerable to bursts or CC, so you can really focus him easily. So it didn't change him much in 3s, basically. It's more of a buff to him on 5s, where there he can like split push and do stuff. But 3s is not really much of a big of a change. With Nami, they fixed, there was a bug with her knock up where it would knock them up for 2 seconds instead of 1.5. It was a really annoying bug. Rickshaws. They fixed a couple of bugs with Poppy, but she still has mana issues in here. Like, she has really high mana costs. Thrice. They nerfed the range of his spells, which is gonna affect him a lot more on 5s than 3s, because on 5s, the more range you have in mid lane, the more like a pressure you have. But on 3s, most comps run melees and short range mages, and you fight most of the time in like tight places, so it's not gonna affect him that much on 3s. But it's gonna be a huge nerf. Not a huge nerf, but it's gonna nerf him in lane and 5s a lot. Thresh. They nerfed his early game, but they changed the way his souls work now. They give him flat instead of like, they used him, give him like 0.7, then it would go down throughout the game. So it's not that much of a difference in 3s, honestly. Twisted Fate. Loaded Dice. It's not gonna make much of a difference in 3s, since he's still not that viable. Because you can't really split push with him, or because the map is so small. And he still lacks mobility in teamfights, he's not that good in teamfights. Vayne, they fixed the bug with the cast range and they nerfed her ultimate. That's still not gonna change much about her in 3s, because her kit is what makes her really strong here. Every E is like, is basically a stun, because the places are so small, and she can kite melees really, really well. And after we get Wuthering King, she becomes insanely strong. Fix the bug with Warwick, not that important. They nerfed the damage with his E, his Axe E. Which I think is deserved, because he does a lot of damage, and he's still really tanky. They changed Jax, Katarina, and Shins, where they can't dash or leap or jump where they were taunted, which is a good change. But he's not breaking the shield. This means like, if you didn't do damage while you hit someone, like with Kayle for example, and you don't do damage and she still dies afterwards, you still get an assist. The items change. Spirit Visage and Call. I like this item and Spirit Visage, but on like tanky melees, if you buy this early on, it will make you really tanky, but it would take a lot more damage from you, because it costs so much. So I think it's still better to go with the new Iron Solari, because it gives so much to your team and it still makes you tanky. Spirit Visage is also good, but you shouldn't rush it early on. It's better to get it later on in the game, as like a 5th item or 6th item. Banshee's Veil, I like the new change. I tried it on Singed, and it works really well for him on late game, but a Spirit Visage I think is better right now, because of how much magic is this. You get so much from it than Banshee's Veil. Guardian Angel changes. There is no Guardian Angel in 3s, so we're gonna skip that. Aegis and Iron Solari, as I said, they are really good right now on 3s, and having at least one Iron Solari in the team makes huge difference in team fights, because it negates so much damage from the other team. Later on, King nerfed the duration by 1 second, which is really not that much of a difference. I think if they wanted nerf it, they should have lowered it to 2 seconds instead of 3. Warren's mail, they reduced the cost and the slow duration, that not that much of a difference. Same thing for Omen. Frozen Heart, they reduced the cost. Other than Ryze, I don't think it's worth buying any other champion right now. New icons, Summoner Rift, we're gonna skip that. They removed the Needless Large Rod and Deathfire Grasp, and they also remade Torch, and now they enabled the Landry's Tournament and Seeker's Arm Guard. Also, they returned Moonflare's Petal Blade. Right now, I don't, other than Vlad, I don't see which champion could use this, because if you bought this, you would lose so much damage, and if you wanted tankiness, you could have gone for other items, and it doesn't really benefit bursty AP champions. It's more of for tanky ones like Vlad or Ryze. Blackfire Torch remake. This actually is a shame. It's gonna make bursty AP mages more viable on the map, and tanky AP mages less viable, because the not less viable, but you would tend to go more for AP mages now than like bursty ones than the short ranged ones like Amumu or something. Wugulit Switch Cap, they buffed the armor and they remade the parts where you can build it from Seeker's Arm Guard, Blasting Wand, Amplifying Dome. I think this is a good change to it, and you'll be buying it a lot more often now because the Blackfire Torch remake. And some champions don't benefit from Blackfire Torch as much as Witch Cap. It's melee attacks. They changed how Valmau targets champions. They fixed like a bug where when you leave his lair, he started twitching. It's not that much of a difference. That's not much changes for that. Ready shake. That's basically it for the patches rundown. Thank you for watching, and if you like this and want me to make more of patches rundowns, hit the like button and make sure to leave a comment. Thank you for watching.